Today I'm making French onion soup. Very delicious and easy to make. I'd like to share the recipe with you. It's better than the restaurant in Quebec, Canada that we ate last time when visited. Welcome to Saigon Cook Travel. I am Saigon Cook. Please come to the kitchen and I show you how. This is my aromatic ingredients. Ginger, garlic, shallots, white part of green onions, and this is Worcestershire salt, Italian seasoning, salt and pepper, onion flakes, onion powder, garlic powder, and no salt seasoning. And absolutely we need to have red wine, and here is vegetable stock. My husband is vegetarian, so I use vegetarian stock. But if you are not, you can use beef stock. It's maybe better. Here I'm started by chopping my aromatic ingredients into a small size pieces. I want to saute them with oil so that it bring out all flavors and aroma, and all of them I need to chop finely so that they disappear in the soup. It make the soup tastier without anything visible. They thing that we want to be visible is the onion thread after we cook. The same thing I do right now is with garlics, and the next thing I will do is shallots. So if you want the exact measurements, please click to the in the description box below. I write down the measurements for you. Now all in the bowl in front of me here is white onions that I also chop finely. These five things will go into the soup, and we cook it down, cook them down so that they make the part of the soup. And that makes the soup taste delicious because of them. So this is the onions, the white onions. You can use yellow onion, it doesn't matter. Or like this time of year is springtime, you can find Vidalia onions. It's softer in texture and it's sweeter. So for the rest of onion, I will thread them. That means I cut it lengthwise, because after we cook, we want those onions to be visible and that look nice that way. So here I have a stalk of celery, and you can see that I remove on the string right now. I don't want any string in my soup, and I do it this way so that the celery also cook down in the soup. So you can see, because I don't use any meat product, no beef stock, no pork stock. We need any vegetable that cook down to replace the umami part of the meat. Now, in my cast iron skillet, I put some oil in I use olive oil here, but you can use any oil. Then I saute my aromatic ingredients until they blondie. You don't let them burn. Be careful, because the garlic tastes bitter when you burn them. So now onto my skillet is celery, chopped celery, and small size chopped onion. I cook down for a little bit for a few minutes, and then I add my other onions. And here in the bowl is the seasoning. Like I said, Worcestershire sauce, salt and pepper, Italian seasonings, powder. If you don't have Italian seasoning powder, you can use provincial seasoning. That means rosemary, lavenders, parsley, all those things. Those leaves, they dry, so they concentrated, and you need to just a few, like a tablespoon or a teaspoon or so. Now we come back to my skillet, and you can see now my onion become translucent. Now this is the time we can add the seasoning in, and here in my bowl I add a little red wine, and I added Worcestershire sauce in as well. And I add them into my skillet now, and I will saute them for 3 to 5 minutes so that the flavors concentrate. You want it cooked down before you add more liquid, that means the stock. The reason we need to cook down here so that the wine evaporates, so that when we eat, we don't taste wine. We can smell a little wine, and the flavors is blended together nicely. Now we are on to the bread. Normally you will put the bread on top of the soup and with the cheese on top, and you will bake or broil in the oven. But here I use cast-iron skillet on the stove, so that you don't need to, I'm lazy to clean the stove, the oven, so I use the stove top as well. So on my skillet, I use a little butter for the coating, and then I grill my sourdough bread, both sides, to be crispy. And then after that, a little butter on top, and here I sprinkle Parmesan cheese. Normally, for the French onion soup, they will use Gruyere cheese, but your choice, you can choose whatever cheese you like. So I use Parmesan cheese, provolone, and cheddar. My husband especially loves cheddar cheese, so it need to have cheddar for him. So this my onion soup is done. I tasted it. It's wonderful, delicious, concentrated flavor. It's so good. You must try this. You must try my recipe. And if you do, please let me know in the comment section below how it goes. For you to be new to my channel, please subscribe for encouragement to me to do more videos. So after my cheese melted on top of the bread, I put on top of my bowl, And that's to it. Yeah, I need to divide now. Thank you for watching. I hope I inspired you to make this for yourself and your family. Please like, share my channel and subscribe to my channel for the next videos. Thank you. Bye-bye.